Pardon me, mistress.
What?
My apologies for the imposition, mistress, but I'm new to the city and I seek a place to buy a hot meal.
Well, you don't want to go anywhere near the South Gate. The few places that are still open down here are expensive and bad. But if you head up by Reed Avenue towards the tower, I'm sure you'll find somewhere to take your lunch.
Thank you, mistress. Pardon, mistress. Do I know you from somewhere? You are familiar to me.
I don't think so. Who are you?
I'm Kian Alvane. I'm an Azadi apostle. I just arrived in the city.
Why are you telling me this?
Honestly, mistress, I'm not certain. It seemed the right thing to do. Perhaps I simply wanted to speak with someone who is not Azadi to find out what you truly think of my people.
What I think of your people? I find you, Azadi, arrogant and full of yourselves. You believe you have a right to impose your politics and religion on others. And you actually have the audacity to believe that we should be grateful for that.
Your honesty is refreshing, mistress, though I do not agree with your views.
It's not a question of agreeing or disagreeing. It's a question of facts. You invaded our lands, you imposed yourselves on us.
We delivered you from a brutal and deadly enemy. We liberated your city. We fed your hungry and housed your homeless. We made your land safe again. Without us, you would not be here. Without us, your people would be scattered, broken, dead. Your cities would be in ruins and your temples burned to the ground. We have only done what we know to be right. We wish only for you to walk in the light of our goddess, to hear her word and to know her love. Tell me, mistress, how have we wronged you? How have we imposed on you with our charity and goodwill?
Charity and goodwill? Is that what they call a military occupation these days? Don't mistake gratitude for love, Azadi. A lot of people were grateful that you liberated Mercuria from the Tyran hordes. Others are grateful for what you've brought with you. Technology, airships, exotic goods, increased trade. And your soldiers, they've made the Northland safe against our enemies, and Mercuria's streets secure to walk at night, as long as you're human, of course. I'm embarrassed to say there are even those who are happy you've rounded up all the non-humans and stuck them in a ghetto. So sure there are those who are grateful and those who have gained a lot from your presence here. As for the silent majority, well, who wants to rock the boat when there's food on the table, a roof over your head, and a job to pay the bills? But ask those who are no longer allowed to speak their minds, to walk the streets, or to practice their religion. What do you think they'll say? Ask a sentinel minstrel, if you can find one, what they felt when you leveled their holiest shrine to the ground to make room for your tower. Ask those who've had their homes raided and destroyed because they weren't born human, because they practiced magic, or because they didn't worship your goddess. Ask the Dolmari or the Zid about being forced to relocate and live inside the walls of the ghetto while they await an uncertain fate. Do you think they will sing your praises? Do you think they've bought into the whole charity and goodwill song and dance? You came here under the pretense of liberating us, but instead you've imprisoned us. You've taken our sovereignty and you've taken our faith. You're even trying to take our individuality away. You want to make us into you. It won't work. In the end, people won't stand for it. If you hadn't come to our lands, we might still be homeless, hunted, hungry, but we'd be free. And freedom, Azadi. Freedom is worth a lot more than you will ever know.
You have strong feelings regarding this matter.
Strong feelings? I shouldn't be talking to you. I have to go.